welcome back. And if you joined us late, I'm having the best time, and we're learning things together. And if you want to learn more about good health and the habits, and especially for children, the food that we choose, we have two experts here today, and I'm delighted to have with me Tom Harvey. And Tom is owner of several Subway restaurants. And many people think about fast food places is promoting what I call junk food. Well, he's here to say that's not quite true, because you don't have junk food. And next to him is Mary Kayrouz. And Mary is a registered nurse from Anderson County. And you're involved in the United Way, right?
At Anderson
County. And this is a big deal. This is a World Food Day, and I didn't know that is October 16th.
Right.
Now, I'm not sure what World Food Day means, but anyway, that's what October 16th. What is it? Do you know?
Right.
Well, we think it's just a great opportunity to talk about, you know, fresh food, fresh fruits, fresh vegetables, the things you should be eating.
Sure.
Brings
awareness.
Why do some people think that it costs more money to eat healthy? I've heard people say that, I can't afford to, that's a lot more money than my budget will.
Right, and a lot of times it's the seasonal harvesting that will dictate some of that. And so the best advice I think we can give those who feel that way are to really watch the markets and watch the grocery stores. The grocery stores have sales and coupons, and the farmer's market has great deals, especially with the SNAP program, the Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program, where they have a program that offers $5, $6 worth of vegetables and fruits. If you put that on your EBT card as a SNAP recipient, you then get $10 extra of free tokens to buy more fruits and vegetables. That's the best deal in town. And so not a lot of people know about that. But each farmers typically like to keep their prices about the same. They all support each other and don't want to compete in that regard. But you can find your favorite deals at different markets. There are different supermarkets that have better prices than others.
Yeah.
And, buying fresh and buying things you know you're going to use within a few days, because the shelf life sometimes on some of these fruits and vegetables is not as long as some of the prepackaged foods. But I like to tell people that as long as they budget and plan and use what they have and be creative and teach the kids to get involved in what you're doing and get them involved in preparing and cutting. And the more fun you make the food look, the more they're going to start asking for those fresh fruits and vegetables. And, there are ways, and there are many opportunities in communities that teach, programs that teach people how to best shop on a budget within their means for fresh products, fresh foods. And, you always hear, if you stay around the perimeter of the grocery store, you'll buy the freshest foods and the healthiest foods. Once you get into the center aisles, have you heard that? If you walk the perimeter of the grocery store, you're going to see more fresh options. That's where the produce is, and that's where the dairy is, and that's where the juice is. And once you start going into the middle, up and down, that's where you're going to find the prepackaged foods, manufactured unhealthy additives and preservatives. And they do cost more because of all that packaging. So that's where some people get confused and misled. Those are the foods that can cost more and not be of greater value nutritionally. So...
Most people would know that there is a farmer's market available.
Absolutely.
In most places.
Right. Not all, but most.
And we even support our local farmers by doing that. And everything is really fresh.
It is. And delicious and colorful right now. I worked at the farmer's market this morning, and there was just a rainbow of colors at the farmer's market with the fall fruits and vegetables. And it's just lovely. It's beautiful. And each time I visit, I try to promote to everyone there, hand out tote bags. if I can get a plug for the farmer's market tote bag with our hours, let's go to the farmer's market. So we pass out free tote bags with information, recipes on what's being harvested, what's available. We have sites online.
How would somebody get something like that?
You just have to go to the farmer's market.
The farmer's market is giving...
Yes. Well, this
hold,
is... A,
hold it
This
up.
Is a program... Oh, great. Thank you. This is a program that Eat Smart, Move More is involved with. We partner with our farmer's market, which is managed by the Parks and Rec Department in Anderson County. And our Eat Smart, Move More marketing department in Columbia will print these bags for us. And I like to go to the farmer's market and count how many bags I see at the market. And I see them all around town at other shops and stores. But it's just a great way to remind yourself that this is my farmer's market bag. And, you know, in Anderson, the farmer's market is open Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. So and through November.
Take your children. And
it's fun. We have fun children's days. We're going to have a fun day on October 7th. I think that's the first Saturday in October. And we have kids' activities. We help them plant a garden. And we teach them about fresh fruits and vegetables. We have games. We have vegetable costumes that people walk around in just to kind of create a fun atmosphere. We have music, so face painting, all the fun children's activities, because we want the farmer's market to be friendly and inviting for everybody.
And this is a little coloring book. This is adorable. And it has all kinds of fruits and vegetables and things that children can color.
And great little facts about foods and nutrition inside.
And facts about nutrition.
Okay. Yeah.
And this... Subway is giving these away, right?
Correct. If you come to the Share the Color event, then yes, you will be given one of the coloring books for all the children. If the adults want one, they're free to do some coloring as well.
So this is going, World Food Day is October 16th. And so you're kind of zeroing in on
around that
time
date,
of the year.
Right. Our five events will go around that date.
And it's a harvest time.
It is. That's it's
true.
A wonderful time to come out and do something fun around food and community.
As a Subway, you're participating in all of this, your Subways.
Exactly. It's just a great opportunity for us to show that, you know, when kids are making their choices about what to eat, maybe what to put on their sandwich, whether it's at Subway or whether it's at home, that, you know, if they're looking at the colorful vegetables to put on their sandwich, it's probably the best choice to put on their sandwich.
And as a registered nurse who works in healthcare situations, what advice can you give quickly to parents maybe that do the grocery shopping and the buying? What are some of the tips that, because you're obviously into this.
Sure.
Advice can you give? Because everybody's watching their food dollar.
Right.
They should be if they're not.
Sure. Yeah. Well, and I just like to keep it very simple and tell people to, you know, buy foods that you know are good for you. You know that will help build strong bones and have vitamins and nutrients included. And be an example for your children. They want to eat what you eat. So to be a role model with good nutrition and active living, that's the best thing that you can do for your child is to teach them. And you could take them grocery shopping with you. You can help let them help you make your grocery list. And when you let them help prepare food, you can cut fun shapes with cookie cutters, your cheeses or your vegetables or your sliced meats if you're going to build a sandwich or add something to a layered casserole. They love to participate and they love to see home-cooked meals and family meals together. It makes a big difference in the choices that they're going to make.
Yeah, so getting your kids
make it
involved,
a family event, absolutely.
Take them, and it isn't always easy, but take them with you to the farmer's market or the grocery store.
Absolutely, yes. Grow a garden in your backyard, even if it's in a container of potted soil.
Yeah.
Let them, teach them that it's important to grow healthy, fresh foods, fresh and local.
Share the Color.
Yes.
Upstate. Share the Color. This is an ideal time with fall and all the fruits and vegetables and things that we have available, and apples and things in the fall of the year.
Right.
And we need to be sure we have those things.
Right.
buy an apple instead of a candy bar.
That's right. Apple's an option. Is the apple a healthy option?
Yeah, we have apples at Subway as well.
As opposed to a bag of chips.
Oh, you do?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Okay. All right. So. Yeah. Well, I'm on your team. I think this is great. So, Tom, as a Subway owner, you promote healthful choices in your...
Of course. Right. That's one of the staples of Subway is that, you know, we're the healthy place, you know, the healthier place to go as far as fast food restaurants go. And, you know, I'm proud to be a Subway owner because I think it's, you know, it's a great option for kids and for families.
Okay. So service and workshops free in October. And the so that would be if they need to know what day a certain place would be open for letting kids make their own sandwiches. They just click on
Eventbrite. Right. Share the color, upstate South Carolina. Eventbrite.com.
Okay.
So and we can put that up on the screen.
So let's all get together and pledge that we're gonna have good healthful choices for ourselves and our kids.
Absolutely.
Okay. And if it's there, they'll eat it.
Right.
Exactly.
And if you get them involved and let them make choices.
Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you so much.
For your expertise.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you very much.
This was fun.
Eat well.
It's going to be a fun day.
Take a walk.
That's right.
This is the most wonderful time of the year. We need to get out and enjoy it. Stay happy. We'll see you next time.